The ocean is full of water. Water is bad for cameras. So how do they take pictures of it? Stop asking questions and watch this segment with Erica Hernandez.
The Earth's ocean isn't just wide, it's deep. Really, really deep. The average depth of the ocean is 12,000 feet. That's like if you took the Empire State Building and stacked it up 10 times. It's also dark. At a depth of 600 feet, or half an Empire State Building, sunlight is reduced so much that no photosynthesis can happen. Keep going down to a depth of 3 Empire State Buildings, there's no detectable sunlight at all. The very deepest parts of the ocean can be 36,000 feet deep. That's almost 7 miles. How do scientists even begin to explore these crushing depths? To find out, I'm meeting with one of the world's top ocean explorers and the first female technology fellow at National Geographic, Katy Croff Bell.
I don't know what it is about the ocean that inspires me. It's huge, it's vast, it's mysterious. There's so many things that are still yet to be found, yet to be discovered. And I guess it's sort of that mystery and calling of the sea that inspires me.
With more than 40 deep water, oceanographic, and archaeological expeditions under her sea belt, I can't think of anyone better to show me some of the technology used to explore the deep ocean. Like this Dropcam. This camera setup has to survive thousands of pounds of pressure pressing on every single square inch. Because of this crushing pressure, the deep ocean was a mystery for scientists and explorers for centuries. Even today, more than 80% of the ocean is unmapped and unexplored.
It's just in the last 50 or 60 years that people have developed different types of tools like submersibles or remotely operated vehicles or drop camera systems like these that we've really been able to see and make discoveries in deep waters where we could never, ever do that before.
Although the technology behind the Dropcam is quite impressive, there really aren't that many parts. Inside here is a glass ball, used for buoyancy. There's a structure to hold the camera and the lights, since it gets a little dark down there, and a container for oily, smelly fish. Once we put all the pieces together, we're ready to set sail. On a normal expedition, Katy would be leading a team of scientists, sailors, and marine engineers. But today's mission is a little more intimate. We're joined by her husband, Rich Bell, an oceanographer and marine biologist, and Roxa, their daughter. The family isn't just giving me a crash course on oceanography and technology, they're also showing me how to sail. Once we find a good spot to place the drop cam, we work together to get it into the water, and it's headed to the bottom of the bay. In the deep ocean, footage from this camera might have images no human has seen before, even entirely new species.
I am so in awe of everything you do. You use so many different things in your job. And I hope that you get to continue exploring and finding out really cool stuff. And I will just call me next time you find a ship.
Okay. Absolutely.